guys, it's Sarah, and today I have a TBR video for you. This is for the Buzzword Readathon, which is going to be next week, starting on Monday, March 18th, and goes through the 24th. And this one is going to be hosted by Books and Lala, who is the main host for it, and she has been bringing in guest hosts every round, which has been a lot of fun. And this time she is doing this with Chelsea from Chelsea Darling Reads. I love both of those ladies, so I will leave their channels down below for both of you guys to go check out if you haven't already. And the buzzword for this round is actually six different words, and I really like the way that they did this. So they decided to do who, what, when, where, why, and how. So any book that has the title or subtitle with any of those words in it counts, and you're supposed to just read books that have any of those words in it. And I thought that was really interesting. I like that there's six of them, so we really have a variety, and I'm excited about this one. So what I did was, I do have priorities for this readathon, and I will talk about those first, and then I will show you all the other books that I have on my shelves that have those words in them, and those will be kind of like more options if I can get to them type of thing. But I thought it'd be fun just to pull them all out and see what I have and see what I can get through throughout the week. But I do have four definite 100%. These are my priorities. This is what I'm starting with. The first three that I'm going to talk about are actually books that I am reading for my materials for children class that I'm taking this semester. And I have a big reading project due at the middle of April, actually. So I do need to make sure I get these books read. And I thought it would be fun to pick out the ones that have these words in the titles, because I do have three of them, and read them for this week. So what I did was, I pulled all those out, and I'm going to make those definitely my number one priorities throughout the week. And if you want to see a full list of the books I'm planning to read for my class, I'll leave that video linked down below, because I did do a video for that. Okay, so the first one is, Who Was Abraham Lincoln? So, who is in the title? And this is by Janet B. Pascal. And it's just a little biography of Abraham Lincoln, and it's got some cute pictures in it. And I'm going to go ahead and give this one a read. The next one is The Girl Who Drank the Moon, and this is by Kelly Barnhill, and the word who is in the title here, and I'm really, really excited to read this one. I've heard such amazing things about it. It actually won the Newbery Medal as well, and I'm just excited to finally say that I have read this book. And this also won the Florida Sunshine Award, which was interesting. That's a state award that is given to books every year, but this is a middle grade, so it should go fairly quickly for me, but I'm really excited to read this one. And then the next one for my class is actually one that I have on audiobook, and that is Where the Red Fern Grows by Wilson Rawls, and that has the word where in it. And so this is one that I'm going to be reading not only for my class, but it's also on the Great American Reads list. And I have read this when I was in fifth grade, I think. Is I remember reading it in class, and I remember it broke my heart, and I think the dogs broke my heart, and I'm a little scared to reread it because I haven't read it since then, because I just remember crying in class. I remember that vividly. So it'll be interesting to read it as an adult and after having my own dogs now. So we'll see how that goes. But I do have that on audiobook, so I do plan to read that one. And number four on my list of I'm definitely going to be picking this up this week type thing is How Not to Die Alone. This is written by Richard Roper, and this is a book that was sent to me for review. It does not come out until the end of May, but it does have the word how in it, and I figured it would be a really great idea to go ahead and get this read now, and then that way when the release date comes around, you know, I can have my review video ready to go and all that stuff, kind of get a little bit of a head start on this one. But this follows a man who is, he works as a public, like kind of a public health person, where he has to find the next of kin for people who have passed away, but no one shows up at their funerals. And, you know, like there's things that need to be taken care of by next of kin, but there's no one around to do that. So he's in charge of kind of tracking those people down and trying to find out what's happening. So I'm excited to read it. It's adorable. Like this cover is so cute. It's not super long, so I think this would be a good one to read during the Buzzword Readathon. Okay, so those are my four priorities for sure. If those are the only four I get to, then that's fine. I'm going to call that a success. But I did pull more. I pulled out all the books that have any of these words in the title, some way, shape, or form. So I'm going to go ahead and go through each word, and we'll talk about which books I have for those options. All right, we will just go in order of the words. So let's start with who. I have two here. The first one is The Girl Who Never Read Noam Chomsky by Jana Kasell. This was recently sent to me for review, unsolicited. It came out March 19th. Or it's coming out March 19th. So that's coming up next week. Yeah. And I don't know if I'm interested in reading this book or not. I have never heard of it. The premise sounds like, I don't know, maybe we'll see. But it does have the word who in it. So I figured I would just go ahead and pull it now and then we'll see. And if I don't read it, then I'll just put it back on my review pile. But it's an option. Another one that I found that has the word who in it is a nonfiction, and this is The Witness War Read, The 19th Wife Who Brought Polygamous Cult Leaders to Justice by Rebecca Musser. And this is Rebecca's actual account of being in a cult and escaping and how she helped to bring them down. So I'm definitely interested in this book. I don't know if I'm going to do a nonfiction for the readathon or not, but it is an option. Okay, let's go on to what. I'm trying to go in the order of how you usually say them. But I have four options for what. And the first one is What She Knew by Gillian McMillan. Gillian McMillan is definitely an author that I want to read more from. I have read one book by her and I liked it, but I want to read more. And I've heard this one is really, really good. And she does write thriller books. So it will definitely be a thriller. And yeah, it has the word what in it. Next one is a recent purchase, and that is What She Left Behind by Ellen Marie Wiseman. And this follows a woman who was admitted into a sane asylum, and I believe it's a dual timeline type thing, and I've heard really good things about it. I have loved the life she was given by Ellen Marie Wiseman. It's one of my favorites of last year, and so I want to read more from her for sure. But I do have this one. It's not a super long book either, and it has the word what in the title. The next one is To Capture What We Cannot Keep, and this is by Beatrice Kolin. I'm not 100% sure what this is, but the cover is fantastic. This was totally a cover by you guys. It's the Eiffel Tower, so it's going to be set in Paris for some sort of whatever. I'm assuming it might be a historical fiction. I don't really know, but it has the word what in the title. It's not super long, and it's a gorgeous book. All right, this next one is not going to happen. But it does have the word what in the title, so I went ahead and pulled it, but it's not going to happen because it's not going to happen. This is going to take me like weeks to get through when I do pick it up. But The Shadow of What Was Lost, and this is by James Islington. This is the first book in the Lucanius trilogy. And so I'm obviously not going to be reading a huge, huge book during a readathon. That's just not something that's realistic for me. Maybe Tome Topple. I could do something like that next time they have a Tome Topple. I'm not sure when the next round's going to be, but this could be an option for that for sure. I do really, really want to read this book. It's just not going to happen for this, but it does have the word what in it. So if anyone has this book and wants to be really ambitious or maybe get one book read throughout the entire thing and do this one, then it could be an option for you too. All right, moving on to where. The first one I have here is Where'd You Go, Bernadette? And this is written by Maria Semple. This is also an adaptation I would like to read because there's going to be a movie coming out this year of it starring Kate Blanchett, I believe. And I really just want to read this, and I've had it for a very long time. So this one, again, is not super long. I'm sure it'll probably go pretty quickly. It's a contemporary, but it does have the word where in the title. Another one for where is Death's Acre. This is inside the legendary forensic lab, the Body Farm, where the dead do tell tales, by Dr. Bill Bass. This is also another recent purchase for me. I got this on Book Outlet. This is very short, and it is a nonfiction, though, so we'll see. Nonfiction sometimes takes me a little bit longer to get through than a regular fiction book, but it does have the word where on it, so it's an option. And then I have two books on my Kindle that have the word where in the title, so I'm going to include those two just in case I pick one of those up. One of them is Where the Crawdads Sing by Delia Owens. This one I also have on audiobook too, so I have a couple options for that. So this could be another audiobook behind Where the Red Fern Grows, because that will be a very quick audiobook. I could probably do that in one day, and then maybe I could go on to Where the Crawdads Sing. That's a possibility as well. And I've heard just amazing things about this book. Just amazing. Almost to the point where I'm a little scared of it, but I've heard it's very, very good. So it's definitely something I want to read. And again, I have it on my Kindle, and I have it in audio form as well. So, and then another one on my Kindle is actually a short story by Jodi Picoult, and it is Where There's Smoke. And I don't know if this coincides with one of her full-length novels, so I'll have to do some research to see if that's something maybe I could read. We'll have to see, because usually if there's a short story that coincides with a novel, I like to do those together, but we'll see. So a little bit more research, but it is there and it is a short story. Okay, so for When, I have one physical here, and that is When We Were Worthy. This is by Mary Beth Mayhew Whalen, and this is a contemporary book that I believe follows a car accident involving a cheerleader, from what I'm understanding. So, but yeah, it's not very long, and it would probably be a quick read for me, but it does have When in the title. And I also have an audiobook that has One in the title, and it's When I'm Gone by Emily Bleeker. This is an author I haven't read anything from yet, but I do have one of her books physically on my shelves. Then I have this audiobook as well. I think I got it for a pretty discounted price on Audible. So yeah, I don't know. That's an option too. We'll see. I don't have any books that have the word why in the title. I don't. That's the only one that I don't have anything. I don't have anything in audio, Kindle, on my shelves, nothing. No word why at all. So, okay, we'll just move on to How. I have one more that has the word how in it, besides my review book that I do plan to read. Okay, How to Make Love Like a Porn Star by Jenna Jameson. This is her autobiography. It is incredibly long, but I'm not gonna lie, there's a lot of pictures in here, which I will not show you. But there's also some like pictures that look like journal entries. So there's that. But I don't know. I don't know if I'll be able to get to this one, but it does have the word how. It is something I want to read. I don't know how long it would take me to get through this, to be honest with you. And there's like some things that are, you know, text messages that are kind of written out and stuff like that. So it may not take me as long as I think it's going to, just because of how long it is, but it is over 500 pages, almost 600. 579 pages of Jenna Jameson. Okay. But yeah, I don't know. It's on my shelves. I could pick it up. It could go faster than I think it's going to. We'll see. I don't know if it's going to happen though. All right, guys, that is it for my Buzzword Readathon TBR options. So definitely four, you know, my three middle grades that I need to read and then my review book. So those are going to absolutely be my priorities. I will probably throw another audiobook in there as well, just because the audiobook I do plan to listen to is going to be very short. So possibly five. We're gonna see how all this goes, but I do have a lot of options. So let me know down below if I get through my four that I definitely need to get to. Let me know what other books I should maybe think about picking up. And if there's an overwhelming majority for one of them, maybe I'll try to pick that one up too. So let me know down below what your thoughts would be on that. And let me know if you guys are going to be participating. Make sure you check out Lala and Chelsea down below for sure and follow along for the readathon. I'm really excited about it. And I will talk to you guys again soon. Hope you have a great day. Bye.